Anybody here ever have a relative in their family that lied like a dog? Not talking about once in a while, talking about all the time. You didn't even believe they were a relative till you saw paperwork on it. Had an uncle like this. His name was Benford Smith Wilson. We called him Uncle B.S. You walk up to him, Uncle B.S., where were you November 22nd, 1963? November 22nd, 1963. Let me think a second. That's the day everybody's supposed to remember where they was. I was working at a school book depository in Dallas, Texas. Houghton Mifflin had just come out with that new math and had them real thick math books. And it's hard to pick them math book boxes up by yourself. And I told them, y'all got to get somebody in here to help me with these boxes. And they hired a fellow named Harvey something. I can't think of his name. He'd been in the Marine Corps and I, of course, in the Navy for 5 years. And he kept bragging about what a great shot your Marine Corps was as opposed to your naval forces. I said, I tell you what, you little pink old commie bastard. This afternoon at lunch, I want you to go back to your boarding house and bring back your rifle. I got 2 tickets to the Texas Theater. Says you can't hit that manhole cover down there by that grassy knoll. You know, he cracked off 4 shots. Damn for President of the United States. Didn't happen to drive by at that exact moment. Well, we felt bad about that. Uncle B.S., where were you December 24th, 1 hour B.C.? December 24th, 1 hour B.C. Working as a part-time night desk clerk, Bethlehem, Israel. Place called the North Star Motor Lodge. Bucked up out their rear end. Trying to get my Caesar census form filled out and stock a Coke machine all at the same time. Up to my butt in caffeine-free Dr. Pepper. Some carpenter strolls in with a pregnant wife, a tired mule, and a bad attitude. Trying to strong-arm me into throwing 2 Roman soldiers out of room 107. I told him, Jesus Christ, man, we're in the people-placing business. Uncle B.S., where were you in March 1836? Life insurance salesman in the Alamo, San Antonio, Texas. Counting Mexicans, trying to get a big fella in a coonskin cap to convince 17 buddies from Tennessee they were in good hands with Allstate. I said, don't let them Mexicans get over that wall, fellas. They'll have this place sheetrocked in about an hour and a half. We can't get to it. Hell, we're covered up. We got all we can do. Uncle B.S., where were you December 7th, 1941? December 7th, 1941. Laying on a beach on a small island off the coast of Hawaii. Trying to get some sun, trying to get some well-deserved R&R. Couldn't get no sleep, though, because some Japanese fellow was behind me trying to get his plane started. Had this look in his eye like he didn't have much to live for. I asked him if he'd ever accepted Christ as his personal savior. He said, no, but he was headed to Honolulu. Had a little one-seater airplane. I begged a ride off of him. It was a tight squeeze, but Japanese folks just fit in your lap. We get headed over there. He's talking kamikaze something. I said, hey, don't be drinking and flying. Hang with me, ma'am, to get better. Hang with me. Uncle B.S., where were you June 6th, 1944? June 6, 1944. Metal detector salesman, D-Day, Normandy, France. Scouring the beach at 4 a.m, black socks and sandals. Helping a gay glass blower named Jean hunt for a friendship bracelet he dropped out of a pair of Speedos earlier that evening. I look out in the ocean, 100,000 surfers come running at me with Tom Hanks and a bunch of green ugly wetsuits. Got guns in a hand, enough luggage to keep a team of bellhops busy for about a month. A bullet from a sand dune parts my hair. Jean takes shrapnel in the hind end. I drag him to a suntan lotion stand, wrap his butt in a beach towel tourniquet. My Geiger counter's beeping like a dope dealer at a crack house picnic. I said, Joan, with this many bullets in the beach, forget about that fag bracelet. Uncle B.S., where were you August 6th, 1945?
August 6th, 1945. Fertilizer salesman, Hiroshima, Japan. Sharing a bamboo duplex with a diesel fuel distributor and a hibachi cook from Kobe Steakhouse. Stacking 40-pound bags of ammonium nitrate barefooted. Sniffing diesel fumes up to my butt and Dunzu knives and all the tempura shrimp you could eat. We're headed to some sumo wrestling matches in Tokyo. I look up in the rearview mirror of the Toyota and seen a big lash. I said, Mookie, did you leave the stove on?
Uncle B.S., where were you December 1955?
City bus driver, Montgomery, Alabama. Wrestling a steering wheel, trying to get a 14-year-old to turn Elvis down so I could figure out how many black people I can squeeze on and still have room up front for the white folks. Best-looking woman in North America crawls on my bus. Prop side hair, legs up to her hind end, 40-D cup staring me right square in the eye. I'm hoping she'll sit in the third seat from the front, my eyeballing seat. I look up in the rearview mirror, damn if Rosa Parks ain't in my eyeballing seat. Now I can sit here and look at Rosa for the next 15 miles or get her to get up and give Miss Nude Alabama her seat. Rosa knows I ain't had a date in 6 months. Picks today to turn into a civil rights martyr. Just goes to show every time I see a good-looking woman, somebody makes a federal case out of it.